As you should know, if you start watching this video, a logical fallacy is an invalid argument, an argument where the conclusion does not follow from the premises, regardless of whether the premises are true or false. Now, it's not uncommon to see the word fallacy used to designate things that are not, strictly speaking, logical fallacies. So it's important to be sure that when you are using the word, you know whether you are referring to a logical fallacy or not. Let me give you a couple of examples of things that we call fallacies, but are not logical fallacies, strictly speaking. We will be talking about the McNamara fallacy and the Concord fallacy. While they are both called fallacies, they are not logical fallacies, strictly speaking. For the record, McNamara was a US government official during the Vietnam War. He wrote reports on the evolution of the situation on the field, focusing on quantitative metrics such as the number of losses on both sides, to suggest that the United States were winning the war. We all know how it ended. This tendency to overemphasize quantitative data and to dismiss qualitative data is now referred to as the McNamara fallacy. But as you can see, not a logical fallacy. Fallacies are not to be confused with cognitive biases. A cognitive bias is a systematic pattern of deviation in the way you treat information and make decisions. These biases increase the chance that you commit logical fallacies, but they are not fallacies themselves. For instance, because of the confirmation bias, you will have the tendency to select and remember only the data that confirm pre-existing beliefs. It's all the more confusing because some cognitive biases are actually referred to as fallacies. The sunk cost fallacy is, for instance, another term we use to designate a bias called the escalation of commitment, where past costs serve as a rationale to legitimate future costs. It's also called the Concord fallacy. The French and the British had invested so much in this plane that they felt like they could not drop the project and kept investing till they understood it was a mistake. Once you are able to identify logical fallacy, then comes the next step. What type of fallacy did we stumble on? The most used distinction is the dichotomy between formal and informal fallacies. Formal fallacies consist in fallacious deductive arguments. It's all black and white. When you can show it's a fallacy, there's no real debate about it. It's not a bit fallacious. It is or it is not. Regarding informal fallacies, it's not that simple. In inductive or abductive arguments, there are gray areas. When you make hasty generalizations, for instance, based on small samples or anecdotal evidence, you cannot say easily that this is fallacious and this is not. It's always open for discussion. And mastering logic is usually not good enough. You also need to be somehow knowledgeable on the topics at hand. To get a better understanding on how to deal with informal fallacies, I highly recommend you watch the videos we have created or curated for you, notably fallacies of the questionable cause.